Hi there, my friends. In this video, I want to talk about Storybook. What is Storybook and why do we need to use it? So, Storybook is open source tool for developing UI components, and we are using this tool in all major libraries and frameworks, such as React, Vue, Angular, Web Components, and all other things. Right now, Storybook is one of the best practices every developer should use, and every company, at least companies where I worked, every team who developing components using React using this tool because of it's a really great one. It allows us to test components and create documentation and a lot of other. So welcome to Travel Scout channel and let's start. In this video, we'll talk about the latest version, is 6. If you want to read or find out a bit more about the previous version, I have a video where describe how to use configure the previous version. You can find it in description. In this one, we will talk about the latest one, and it calls zero configuration. Why? Because of everything what was configured in the previous one, we can skip in this one. So let's start from the installation. Let's go to get start. Install what we need. It's super easy with npx sb init. So let's copy and use it for our project. I created empty storybook project. It's React only. Create React app. So as you see, it's empty project, but we can use it for this one. So let's init. This tool automatically will define what project you are using, is the React, Angular, or any other, and configure it specifically for your project. And now installation was finished. Let's take a look what do we have. So, as we see, package.json was changed and now we have two new commands. It's storybook and build storybook. This one we will use to run storybook. Also, we have one new folder. It's .storybook with two files. Main is the most important. Here we see the configuration for stories, where we can find these stories. It will be in source folder, anywhere. Every file which has extension stories with a file extension. Also, we have default addons for storybook. Also, we have preview with nothing interesting. Right now, we can skip it. Inside source folder, we have stories folder with samples. Okay, let's run storybook and we will see what we have. So, yarn storybook and storybook will be launched. It's the main window of storybook. What we see? The first of all, we have new feature is introduction. And on docs tab, we can see that here are links for configure, learn, and everything what you need to start. On canvas, it's nothing interesting. And we have three samples. It's button, and header and page. Let's start from button. In general, in storybook, we have this canvas tab with a button which we can use. And here in the bottom, we have these addons which were installed by default. The most important here is controls. Right now, it's out of the box, and previously, we used knobs addon, but for 6 version, it was created from the scratch a new one which is almost the same. So, all props we have for this component, we can switch and change here. For example, primary, when we click something, we can see that we see a result in our component, and it's really cool. That's why we are using this tool to test our components. Because of using this tool, you can create different states. Sometimes in application, if you need to create some complex state, it will take a lot of actions to do it, but for this one we can do everything what we need. Also, in this version was added docs as well from the box. So we see that we have documentation. We can add edit everything what we want. we have this component, we can check the code, how it was implemented, and we see that we have documentation for all props in this for this component. For example, let's choose color, and we see that background color was changed and the component was changed as well. Okay, the next one is header, the same, and page. What do we have else on this page? Let's go to canvas, and we can change the zoom, for example, for this component. Also, we can change background, is it light or dark? So if you want to know how it works, you can check my videos about light and dark themes in React components and React application. Okay, let's check this one. Also, we can set this grid. And very popular and important stuff, it's change viewport. For example, for mobile one or for large mobile, you can switch it. It's very great in case you need to test your components for mobile view or any other view. Okay, also we can do it full screen or open in separate tab. It will be in iframe completely this component without storybook. It's a great one. Also, okay, and now let's check what we have inside. Let's go to button. So this storybook is using JS doc markup. So in case we have some component and these comments will be used as documentation. For example, for button, as you see, we have button and primary UI component. Button is component name, and this one is documentation. Also, for all props we have, we defined description for this component, we defined type of this component, and also we have default props. All this data are using here. Okay, let's go to stories. In stories, it's super easy right now, so we need just import React, import our component, create export default this component, and then we need create templates. It's something new. Okay, in this template we see that we can pass different arguments using these template arguments, and passing these arguments then we bind different arguments. For example, is it primary, and all these buttons are here as you see. Okay, it's super easy with already pre-configured components, but let's try with something new. I have one component I created for another project, it's input. Let's copy this component and we will try create stories for this one. So let's create new folder. So we have two files. The first one, index, is just input wrapper, which allows us to pass label, input field components, and errors if we have. Also in styles, we are using styled components. Also, I have a great video about styled components, how to use them. You can find it in description. So let's install just styled components and okay, now we can start creating our stories. What we need? Let's create a new file. It will be index stories.js. It's super easy. Let's copy. Let's take a look on documentation. What we have? We can install, we can write stories. We need to create a file with this extension also. Inside we can default export. So let's do it. So this component will be automatically updated. But we do not see a result. So let's do it. Let's do it this one. So now we can see results. So to have results in this page, let's check what we need. We need create template. It's with this one, so let's copy. And change. So we need input, we need pass arguments. So then we have, for example, it's primary, and we need pass arguments. For this one, for example, we can define some errors. What do we have? Errors, it's array of errors. For example, that's it. And now let's check what we have. So as you see, now we have a new section, it's components. It was used based on this part of title, and we have input. In input, as you see, we have two sections, it's primary and with error. So also, as you see, we are using camel case notation, and here it's with a space. Let's go to canvas. So we have primary with primary label and with error. We see that we have error. Also, we can change everything what we want. For example, for label and for placeholder. It was great. Also, we have type. As you see, it automatically drop down with two options, text and password. So is it password? Yes. How it was achieved? Let's go to index and we see that type. It's props types one of text and password. So Storybook automatically knows what you need. It's cool. The next one, we have docs. For this documentation, as you see, we have primary label with the code. Also, we have the same props, but we don't have any description. To add some description, let's go to component and, for example, and as you see, we have it. Also, we don't have any description for this component. Also, and here, but this parameter looks not cool. Okay, also another feature what we have in Storybook, it's using documentation. So we can write documents with MDX extension. So it's very cool approach when you need to create some documentation. So let's try create this MDX. Okay, and for this one, let's, for example, copy this section. Okay, now it doesn't work. So what we need to change? So we have input. For example, we can leave it as is, and so. As you see, for this one, documentation, it works, it created a new file, a new section is MDX, and we have documentation. But for input, it's using the old one, so we can change it using the next one. We need to change method title according to our stories. In this case, what we have? Components input. Let's MDX update. And now, as you see, in docs section, we can change anything what we want, and this documentation will be according to our MDX file. So we updated this section. So in case you need to create documentation for your components, you can use this tool, and everything what you need you will have here. It's just a regular MDX configuration, and we can create anything what we want with, for example, a description. Okay, to fix this, let's try to change name, because we have two the same names, and this one, let's try. And as you see, we have new result. We have checked, and for example, checked one. And as you see, we have this description, we have components with code, and we have some text and any other component. It's great because of you can add images or videos here, and it will be real great documentation. So it was a sample how we can use this tool for developing component. Really, it's a must-have right now for every developer, and if you want to get more information how to use similar tools in web development, subscribe to Travel Scout channel, and soon you will get this information. So, thank you for watching.